10 trillion bacterial cells in a human body. 99% of the DNA inside of me is not human DNA. It belongs to the bacteria and microorganisms that call this body home. So I imagine taking the shell away, the 1% of my structure that thinks I am alone in here, that washes with antibacterial soap and fears alien invasions. And then while our tiny beings would scream into an incoherent mass, the dissolution of the superorganism making us all go meaningless. I am constructed of so many creatures that have no idea who I am. And a part of it was you. Still is. A single kiss can transfer 80 million bacteria. As our bodies interacted, we went through a deep period of cultural exchange, shaping each other's internal flora, signing microscopic peace treaties, and setting up trade agreements. Touch for touch. The unique mold on the ridge of your hip for the sweat between my toes. The fungus under your fingernails for the fermentations behind my ears. Trade your heart for my empty places. Trade your scars for my misaligned bones. We started to smell differently. The festivals of tiny creatures making love on our skins released the scent of honey from the crook of your neck. Parasites and germs were falling in love all over our bodies and making tiny micro-orgasms about it all day long. But now you are gone. And I cannot explain this to my microbiome. It remembers the deep feed of oxytocin when you would hold my ribs in your hands, that it was almost enough to make up for the acid dip of anxiety when you treated me like a stranger at a party, or when I found that long blonde hair in your bed. Left in poverty, hungry, my microbiome drives my fingers to tug at the back of your neck. It feeds scenarios to my dreaming mind to create a reason to call you, to make you promise you never lied to me, that it was all a mistake, so you can kiss me again and replenish my dying biota. But in some dark corners, in secret, some of the flora are celebrating, creating new blooms in the relief and freedom of my post-colonial body, refusing to grieve their sisters lost somewhere deep in the pores of your skin, and instead creating indigenous forms of leadership in the eyes of my elbows and in the pockets of my teeth. See, I don't miss you, asshole. But there is a community of bacteria in my body with Stockholm Syndrome, and I am left to starve the factions that resist decolonization and find new food for the rebels who are willing to move on with it. After all, as they say, the best way to get over someone is to find a better biology of exchange under someone else.